Nigeria. I'm sorry for that country. Oyegu said that Nigeria was a laughing stock before they took over power. So we let him understand Nigeria is crying stock now, unemployment stock, hunger starvation stock now. But that is not what I'm here to talk about. I'm here to talk about the Mr. Integrity President Buhari. Chai, my people. How can Buhari appoint three dead men as board chairmans and a member? How did that happen? You leave the living. You are not appointing dead people. My country people. Well, Buhari, they try you. Buhari, they try well. You know? He's carrying both the living and the dead along. Maybe the living have disappointed him. And he's trying the dead now. What a demented and confused people we have in government. You can see why we are in a mess in Nigeria. If Buhari cannot carry out a simple task appointing people, you can imagine how he is handling the more serious state matters. Shame on Buhari, shame on APC, and anyone supporting this calamity. Appointing dead people, people that is already dead. The same people Buhari sent condolence message to their family. The same people is appointing now. He sent condolence message to their family before. This is a shame. That means the person that is doing this appointment thing for Buhari, that is the reason why we said Buhari is brain dead. You know, the dead attract the dead. I'm sorry for that country. Buhari must go. That man have nothing to offer. That man have nothing to offer. I'm sorry for that country. It was on the news today. People are still fighting over the dress code of our law schools. The law school. Lawyer want to be dressing like the ladies want to be covering their head, you know, dressing like, you know, introducing their Muslim law into our law school. Why can't you people just agitate for your own Islamic country so that you can go and do your Islam country? So you want to go your Islam school, or better still, why can't you people just go to Sabisa and be living your Sharia life there instead of disturbing the rest of the country? It is a shame. Happy New Year, my people. God bless. Dead civilian family, happy weekend. I salute you all. I don't come back again. The wounded civilian. The wounded one. My people. The Bible says it's only the truth that can, you know, that will set us free. People in the South, let's unite. It is time we unite against our oppressor. Can't you see the people who used to think they stand with Buhari? They are now standing in they are now at the filling station now. That's where they are standing now. People used to, you know, intimidate us, disturb us with they stand with Buhari. They are now standing in the filling station now, sleeping filling station. You have to exchange blows before you can buy fuel in Nigeria. You have to stay for queue for over 3, 4, 5, 6 hours before you can get fuel in Nigeria. You know, this is not new thing. This is not the first time. That's the truth. It happens before. It has been happening before. But what we are saying here is that this very government preach change. They said when they come, they will change things. Things like this fuel scarcity thing will not happen again. That is why they increase fuel. When Jonathan, the former president, tried to remove fuel subsidy, People like Pastor Tunde Bakare led Save Nigerian group. They were disturbing the peace of the country, demonstrating against the past president, saying removing the first subsidy is suffering, he wants to suffer the poor. They said they are fighting for the poor. But Buhari came after a few weeks, he removed it. Now people are sleeping filling station. My question is, where is Tunde Bakare now? They went hiding. What about the human rights and beast activists? Femi Falana and Wolesho Ika, where are these guys now? They used to speak big grammar, talk nonsense against the former president, because that's why some people say it is because of he was from the South South. If not, why are you people keeping quiet now? A lot of nonsense is going on. It's happening in this government. Nobody's saying anything. You people used to insult Jonathan. You used to insult him. Call him a clueless. Call him all sorts of name. Where are these guys now? That's my question. The same brain dead Buhari said before, during Jonathan time, he said that at the time Nigeria is supposed to do better thing or be in the office doing better thing is the time they are spending waiting in police station. But people are waiting in sleeping police station now. You see, the Bible cannot lie. It is what you sow, you reap. What you sow is what you reap. All this noise, these protests, demonstrations against Jonathan was just to, you know, kick these people out so that you can be there. I promise change. What Nigerians are experiencing now is your kind of, is this change? Under the very corrupt government of Jonathan, people can buy chop and eat, go to the market, buy gari, buy pepper and eat. But change come, you can buy anything. Under Jonathan, the corrupt president, everything was so cheap. Life below, everything, transportation. But now that we have change, you can buy anything. When we talk, they said we are the one preaching hate. Where are these guys now? Why are they not saying anything? Buhari is a disaster. There's no way we will make a certificateless president, a man making president, and have a peaceful country. There is no way you will make a brain dead man a president and have a peaceful country. Buhari is a disaster. A complete disaster. First of all, let me tie Dino Malaye what he said yesterday at the Senate. Dino Malaye is the best thing ever happened to the upper chamber in that country, Nigeria. Dino Malaye is the best thing. From 1999 to date, I don't think any senators can contest with Dino Malaye. A courageous leader without an atom of fear. Dino Malaye is speaking for the masses. And yet the Ibishile, the Brendan Yahaya Bello, the Kogi State governor, want him recalled. It's a shame. It is obvious that the governor of Kogi State, Yahaya Bello, has a lesser virus in his brain. He needs some medical checkup. Dino Malaye is the kind of senator I am proud of. Senators from my own state, they are just there warming bench. At the end of the month, they receive salary doing nothing. Nobody even know they are there. But Dino Malaye is the only senator who talk about the corruption that is going on in Buhari government. Dino Malaye yesterday, he was defending the masses. He asked a question that Buhari 2016 budget was a fraud. He failed. He put Nigeria in more masses were suffering. People suffers more when 2016 Buhari budget. 2017, the same thing. He said 2018 will also fail because people are stealing left and right in Buhari government. That's what he said yesterday. And that's just the truth. That man supposed to be APC member, but he forget about the name of his party, but he's telling the truth, and people hate him for that. People like us, I am proud of Dino Malay. I'm proud of him. I just want Nigerians to know, Dino Malay, we should all pray for that man. I'm not saying he's perfect, and he never claimed that he is perfect, but he's the only senators in the house who can talk without fear or favor. He's the only senator in the house who fear nobody. He don't even fear Buhari. He said the truth. May God continue to bless that man. May God continue to bless that man. I see he's just like somebody like my brother, Nnamdi Kanu. Yeah, I remember Nnamdi Kanu. You know, they said Nnamdi Kanu is your enemy, is your enemy. That's what they tell you, people from the West. People from the south, people from the east. But Nnamdi Kanu is not a problem. Go and watch Nnamdi Kanu video. Go and watch his speech. Tell me where he ever attacked the poor in the north. Tell me where Nnamdi Kanu attacked the poor masses in the southwest. Tell me anywhere Nnamdi Kanu attacked the poor masses in the south. Tell me where Nnamdi Kanu attacked poor masses in any part of Nigeria. He was talking to the elite. He knows these people, the elite, they speak one language. They have no religion. They have no political party. They unite in stealing. They are the one killing our future. They are the one killing that country. When he was talking about separation, he knows that there is nothing we can do to change that country except separation. Biafra, the name Biafra, is their greatest nightmare. It will be their nightmare forever. They fear that name Biafra. So they don't cook up propaganda to rubbish his name, to tell you he is your enemy, he is the one agitating war. He said referendum, that was what he preached. He never carried gun, he never killed anybody. But they said the IPOs are the terrorists. I don't want, know that I like talking about the IPOs. Something leads to it. I don't just talk about IPOs. Whereas the harmful army S-men who travel from state to state, massacring people, but they never call them terrorists. Look today, Nnamdi Kanu is nowhere to be found. And my people, the Igbos, they are the people selling themselves. The Igbos are their own problem. I said it before. There's a lot of people were offended. They were sending me text messages. I don't give a shit. Igbos are their own problem. Nnamdi Kanu is nowhere to be found. Ever since the stupid army do their python dance in his house, everybody supposed to occupy the Igbo supposed to block everything. We are not even not to agitate for Biafra now, but to ask, where is your brother? The government don't want him, even though he died. It's not their business. Provider is not preaching. He is not preaching Biafra. Now there is nowhere to be found. The government is not doing their thing. They don't give a shit. You that are supposed to give a shit, ask questions. Where is Nnamdi Kanu's father? Where is the mother? Where is Nnamdi Kanu? At least ask the government. You are the one who do the python dance there. Ever since you do your python dance there, it's nowhere to be found. You are not agitating for Biafra. You are asking questions. But all of you keep quiet. Nobody is talking. You are your own problem. You are your own problem. Not until you stand your ground and say enough is enough. Look at Inomotus. Look at Inomotus. They want to bring that man down. I don't want to talk about Inomoto before. I was studying the case. I just keep quiet. That's okay. Let me see what the government is trying to do. What they are trying to do is to bring that man down because he refused to relocate to Abuja or Lagos. I respect Mr. Innocent. I respect that man. Somebody asked me before, hey, Mr. Silverman, Ms. Wounded, why can't you come and buy land in Lagos? I said, why should I buy land in Lagos? Buy land in Lagos for what? Buy land in Lagos for what? I don't want to buy land in Lagos. I don't want to build any house in Lagos. If it is 4 hours I want to build, I'll build it in my own state. A Lagosian cannot come to my state and build a house. Or buy land in my state. Why should I buy land in Lagos? I don't give a shit about Lagos. My state is my Lagos. My responsibility to make my state a Lagos. This is what Inomoto is doing. Instead of him to relocate to the Abuja or relocate to them Lagos, he stays in his father land. And people hate him for that. Yes. Now they want, they are doing their propaganda, doing their wayo wayo to bring the man down. Me, I have studied the case. Tell me what is what they call it, called the stupid EFCC Magu doing in this case. You know, they are trying to, you know, EFCC trying to intimidate him for what? He's not your governor. He never be governor. He never be president. Never be senator or steal any money from your government. Tell me what the business of EFCC in this case. Their plan is to bring that man down. And we know it. If it was Dangote, if it was Dangote, he would be given a license to import, manufacture, and build refinery. But he's an evil man. Evil man is nobody. That's what they are doing to that man. Instead of our government to support a man with a great vision, but they want to kill him. They want to bring him down. They want to bring him down. If it was Hausa man, hey, nobody will touch him. Nobody will touch him if you dare it. They will come and do python dance in your house. Example, look at this bosser, Anthony Joshua. This is what they did to him. This is what they did to him today. He's making UK proud. He's making UK proud. Anthony, you know him? Anthony Joshua. Now he's representing UK. This is what they do when you see somebody that is growing. These evil people, these Buhari evil people, they will do everything. They'll bring you down. It is jealous. This jealousy. They must bring you down. This is what they are doing. We have a lot of potentials. But this corrupt government, especially this Buhari corrupt, evil government, can't let us, you know, maximize our potentials. That's just the truth. They want to bring him down. That's it. You know, he's manufacturing, you know, his cars in his own land. He didn't go to the Abuja. He didn't go to the Lagos. They say, what? The region we said we want to, it must remain in darkness. And this man is trying to bring, you know, trying to let, because they know very soon maybe the man will expand, the whole world will come and, you know, there will, the first time an African man manufacturing cars, and this is what our government is doing to him. Look, this is what they are doing to him. People like us will always say the truth. This is exactly how the federal government led by Obasanjo, killed Ebetum Cement. Go and read those that who know politics, people who follow this politician bumper to bumper, what is going on in Nigeria. Go and ask of Ebetus mate. This is how Obasanjo kill it and gave the license to Dangote and gave the license the monopoly right to import and sell cement. How he likes. He's the one to put price. Nobody will challenge him. Because they don't just want people from the southeast to grow, people from the south to grow. What about Ifa Yumba? He suffered the same similar case. Now it is innocent mortals. Tell me what in EFCC business in this case. The court said that stupid bank should pay him his money. The bank said no. Then I'm going to call the government. Kill him. You must destroy his company. The only company that manufactures cars in Nigeria. This is shame to our leaders. Say shame to Nigeria. That's why some of us say Nigeria cannot grow. Division is the best. Nigeria cannot grow. Division. If I tell you how much these people is stealing now, how much politicians is stealing left and right? That is what Dino Malaya said yesterday. They are just stealing our money. Buhari cannot say he know nothing about it. All this money they are stealing now. Buhari is aware of it. An APC member knows. But they don't want to say anything. But they will talk. After we keep Buhari out of power, they will talk. They will talk under Mr. Integrity. When they say Mr. Integrity, how do you mean Mr. Integrity? Well, how? When you say Mr. Integrity, how? How? What makes you say Buhari have integrity? What do you mean integrity? People are crying now. I said, you guys are crying for nothing yet. Let us wait. Just wait. Let us enter 2018. Nigerians will know, will now, the real crying will begin. The real crying will begin in 2018. By then, you will know that Buhari government is what we call evil government. Just wait. Don't cry yet. It is the truth that we stand for. Look at how they are stealing money left and right. People are suffering. They tell you how much Buhari spent celebrating his birthday. White beggars on the street. Poor masses cannot get two square meal a day. When Buhari lost election before, it is the masses who demonstrate on the street who killed themselves while his student was, you know, schooling in abroad. Now he's not the president. Eventually, he's not the president now. The Yorubas, Tinubu, the criminal Tinubu makes him president now. It is his student that is enjoying now. But the poor masses still on the street, begging, still on the street suffering. Well, we say the truth. You said we are preaching it. We are the one preaching it, suffering and smiling. Thank you.